Hello YouTube and welcome back to another video. This is Champion2D Rob back again. It has been a while since I made my last video, guys, and I apologise for that. No excuses really. To be honest, my mind's just not really been into YouTube at the moment. Just spending more time just sort of playing the games as opposed to just sort of talking about them. But it's not just been that. It's been other factors, other things that have gotten in the way. I'm also having a few technical issues with my phone, which I use to basically record my videos ever since I started the channel. So I'm hoping to upgrade my equipment as soon as I get some money for it. So, I mean, aside from the technical issues, it really has sort of more of been that my mind has not really been into YouTube. It's not necessarily that I've lost interest in YouTube, it's just the fact that I feel things need to step up in terms of the quality of the videos and stuff, and I'm working towards that slow and steady, but it's just a combination of having the time to actually work on these videos, and at the moment I just don't have much time, so it's kind of slowed down the videos because you know, I know you guys that have subscribed to me, of course you guys are perfectly fine with what I put out there currently, you know, but I think, you know, for me to get a degree of satisfaction of what I do, it has to kind of evolve over time, and if it doesn't evolve, it just stagnates, then it does eventually just become boring, and then in turn you will start to lose interest. That's just the way things are, that's how life works. You know, I will be putting out videos, of course, but I think between now and New Year's, things are going to be a bit inconsistent. Things won't be very regular, unfortunately. Just got a lot of things on my plate right now, so I will be putting out videos, but they just won't be at any consistent rate between now and New Year's anyway. By the New Year, you know, things hopefully will start to pick up steam a lot more. I will try and put out a video every now and again, but it really just depends on what's been going on, and of course whether I feel like putting up a video. But anyway, all that said and done, here's a video now for you guys, and it is a pickups video. Now, initially this video was going to be just a video game pickups, but to be honest, I don't have that much video game related stuff. I do have a few items here, of course. But I just haven't been buying a lot of games lately because I'm trying to save up for a PS4. I'm not really saving up for it at the moment, but I've been paying off other stuff and whatnot. But I'm hoping that's really been my main sort of thing at the moment to try and get one very very soon. And in the meantime, sort of my other interest has mainly been on sort of Blu-rays, movies, and animated features and stuff like that. That's really what I've been enjoying in terms of watching and whatnot. Of course, I'm still playing video games. I've been playing a lot of video games. In fact, I've been doing a lot of emulating, just a lot of stuff that I don't own, stuff that I want to play, as well as playing a lot of my PS3 games, sort of like replaying some stuff that I've played prior, playing some of my backlog titles. I've been playing some of my PS2 games. I've been playing a lot of fighters, a lot of 2D fighters, just using the arcade stick that I picked up for the PlayStation 2 not too long ago. Just playing a lot of Samurai Showdown. I've been also been using the stick to play the Capcom collections, the compilations that were released on the PS2, the remastered and remixed editions. That's what I've been playing a lot of. Just playing a lot of beat 'em ups as well. Like playing I've been playing a lot of Final Fight 3, Streets of Rage 2. That's a given. I've actually been playing that on the 3DS. I've been playing the 3D edition of Streets of Rage 2, and really enjoying that. It's been great, and just having fun with a lot of the stuff. And also, while emulating, I've been playing a lot of The Fireman on the Super Nintendo. That's a game actually that I didn't know much about. I knew of it, but I didn't know much about the game. And I started playing it on emulation, and I really enjoyed it. And it's definitely a game that I would love to add into the collection, but the PAL copy is extremely rare and expensive. The Japanese copy is more affordable. It's still pricey, but it's a lot more affordable. And it's definitely something I'm going to consider. But to be perfectly honest with you, the game does feature quite a bit of, well, not a lot, but it has a lot of text to it, like a lot of story-based text and whatnot. And I feel that, I don't know, I don't think I'd like it without the English text. I'm not too sure if there's a translation for it, maybe down the line, which I can use on my Retron 5 possibly. But yeah, I quite like playing it in English, so I don't know if I'd enjoy it as much playing it as the Japanese version alone. But also as well, I quite like playing it on a handheld. Which is how I've been emulating, and which in turn is actually going to lead to my first pickup. But I've been enjoying that game a lot on handheld as opposed to playing on a console. I think that game, for me anyway, I just like playing on handheld. I don't know why, I just do. But anyway, that of course segues into the first of my pickups, and it's a big pickup. It's a decent pickup, and it's something that I've toyed with getting for a long time, and I decided to bite the bullet and check it out. And what I picked up was the JXD gaming tab. This came out a while ago now. It's basically an emulating machine. You can play MAME, Mega Drive, Super Nintendo, Game Boy Advance, PC Engine, etc., etc. And I decided to bite the bullet and I picked this up. And yeah, I've really enjoyed it. I've been playing a lot of beat 'em ups on this. I've been playing a lot of Aliens versus Predator on this. A lot of beat 'em ups that I loved. Unfortunately, there is an app on this, like a pre-installed app, which lets you just download the games automatically. But unfortunately, the list of titles isn't as extensive as I would have hoped, so I have to basically use an SD card and transfer ROM files onto this, which I've yet to do, so I can get some of the other titles that it's missing. Like it's got some great games on here for sure. There's like Cadillacs and Dinosaurs, which I loved as a kid, but certain notable missing ones are like the Golden Axe arcade beat 'em up. As well as Spider-Man Arcade is another one that's missing, and a few others that I love playing, like Metamorphic Force. But some of the other ones, like X-Men Arcade, is on here, and it's great. And also, I've been playing a lot of SNES games on here, as well as Mega Drive games. I've been playing a lot of not Desert Strike. I've been playing a lot of Jungle Strike on this as well. Yeah, it's been really been enjoying that. The Jungle Strike as well as Urban Strike. Been playing both those titles. I quite like playing the strike games on the handheld. I don't know why. So I think those sort of top down or isometric games, I tend to prefer them more on a handheld as opposed to a console. I don't know, I just get into it more, and I like the fact that they're a save state. It's made playing the strike games a lot more bearable, but they're a lot of fun. I'd forgotten how great the strike games were, because even though I have them on the Mega Drive, it's been a while since I played them, so it's been nice to sort of been able to check it out on this. Now, as for the system itself, I mean, I basically paid about 120 quid or something for this. To be honest with you, I'm not I mean, for what it can do, because it can also play a lot of modern games as well. I don't know how the makers of this got away with it, but you can actually download a lot of modern Android games on this. Like you can play Street Fighter 4. I have the reboot of Castle of Illusion on this as well. Plays it fine, and you don't pay for any of it. It's all downloaded for free, which I don't know how they got away with that. But yeah, so it's a powerful machine. But if I'm honest, it's not particularly well built. I don't think it's as I mean for that price. I mean, you and I wasn't expecting, a great piece of quality, But it does the job. I mean, I just bought it mainly for playing emulated stuff, and it does its job, and I'm happy with it. I'm happy with it. So I did have an issue with it at first. I think the first one they sent me, the battery sort of died on me, and I had to send it back, and they had to give me a new one. And it works fine now. But yeah, I'm happy with it. It's not the greatest piece of kit in the world. I advise you that if you are considering getting something like this, just be aware that it's not the best quality. You get what you pay for, basically. But it does what it sets out to do. It plays emulated stuff. So if that's what you want it for, it'll work. Moving on. Okay, so I've got three titles here. These are actually three modern titles. I haven't bought any retro as of late. Basically, there's a lot of retro stuff that I do want to get. A lot of Mega Drive titles that I've been looking at, both on not so much in PAL, but there's some Genesis stuff. I've been thinking about getting some Genesis games, or their Japanese equivalent. There's a couple of stuff, some Japanese exclusive Mega Drive titles that I wasn't aware of until I actually started emulating the stuff, and I was looking down the list of the emulated games. Stuff that I had no idea was even out on the Mega Drive, and I've been playing it on the JXD, and I've been loving it. So I'm looking to pick those titles up for the Japanese Mega Drive at some point, and also on the Super Nintendo. There's a couple of not Super Nintendo, Super Famicom. There's a couple of titles that I'm looking at to get. Unfortunately, these games, they're all like on eBay. They're like £50 and upwards, and I don't know if I can stretch to it right now. Money is a bit tight right now. I just can't really justify paying like, 60, £70 for just one title. It's really hard. I like to be able to make the most of my budget for what I want to get, which is why I haven't been buying a lot right now. But I do have three games here for modern systems. Two are PlayStation 3 games, and one is actually a PlayStation 4 game. Yes, I don't have the system yet, but I thought I would get the ball rolling. And this is definitely a game I'm looking forward to play. And the game is Gianna Sisters, Twisted Dreams Director's Cut. This was originally a digital only game. It's sort of like a 2.5D platform title. And I figured I'd get it on the PS4, so this is like my first PS4 game. Obviously, I've not played it yet. I'm looking forward to doing so at some point. I love the fact that they are releasing a lot of the digital games in physical format. I love that. I mean, yeah, they're mostly coming out for the PS4, which is fine because I'm going to get it at some point. But, I'm glad that they are coming out, and I'm looking forward to checking out Shovel Knight as well. That's definitely one game that's on my radar. So I'm looking forward to getting into Gian Sisters, Twisted Dreams. I've been sort of getting back into some platformers as well. Lately, I've been playing a lot of Rayman Origins on the PS3, and I had that in my backlog for a long, long time. I hadn't played it for a long, long time, and it was one day I just decided to put it on, and I thought it was a fantastic title, great 2D platform game. If you haven't checked out Rayman Origins, definitely check it out. I might look into picking up Rayman Legends as well. I haven't gotten around to getting that one yet. But yeah, really enjoyed that game. I haven't completed it yet. I'm still working my way through it, but it's been a great game. I forgot how great 2D platforming was. It's been a long time since I've played any. So anyway, it's got me back in this mood for sort of 2D platformers and 2D 2.5D platform games, whatnot. So I figured I'd give Gianna Sisters a try. I played the demo of this, quite enjoyed it. I do like the Gianna Sisters. I have the sort of remake of the original on the Nintendo DS. So yeah, definitely looking forward to checking that one out. And the next title I have here for this is for the PS3, and that is Dead Space 3. Basically, really bought it just to sort of complete the trilogy. I have the first two. And even though I've not even played the first two yet, it just bugged me that I haven't the third one, so I just picked up a cheap copy. I know it's considered the weakest of the three games, but I can't, have the first two and not have the third game, so I picked it up on the cheap. It is new and sealed, and I will get round to playing this. I actually have played the demo of this game. I quite enjoyed it personally. So yeah, I look forward to trying this one out at some point as well. And lastly, the game I bought recently, and this is a game that I've been playing quite a bit as of late, and that is Undernight in Birth. Was it Undernight in Birth XE Late? This is a 2D fighter, and it is a great game. It's from Arc System Works. That's the same company that's been releasing the Guilty Gear and Blaze Blue series as well. It's a great fan. It's a great 2D fighter, as you would expect. It's very Japanese. It's got a lot of anime influence. What made this game stand out for me really was I just like the characters. I've been finding what I've started to realize is that a lot of the 2D fighters of today tend to have. I mean, they're all very anime influenced. That's just the way it's going to be. I'm fine with that. But I like them when the characters are quite visually interesting, and this one has a lot of visually interesting characters. And I've played it. It's actually really, really cool. I mean, as you would expect from an Arc System Works game, it's not like like a Street Fighter game. It doesn't have the same flow as Street Fighter. Even though this game is actually very accessible, I actually found this game very easy to play. I didn't even look at the manual to look at the moves, and I was already pulling off moves and combos. It's not a difficult game to get into, but saying that though, it's definitely, while it is an accessible game, it's still fairly technical, as you would expect from most Arc System Works games. The moves are easy to pull off, but you do have to sort of know your combos and learn timing and stuff, which is typical of Arc System games. They're brilliant, but this is definitely, I think, one of the more accessible of the Arc System Works titles, and it's definitely one I think people should check out. It's actually really, really good. Really enjoyed it. Love the character designs. It looks beautiful. And of course, you know me, guys. I love these styles of games. I'm looking forward to checking out Guilty Gear. What's it called? XRD Sigma, I believe. I was actually going to get the current version that's out at the moment, but I know that there's actually going to be a revision coming out very soon, so I'm going to hold off for that. But yeah, this is definitely a very cool title, guys. Definitely check it out. That's Undernight in Birth. Very cool game. Unfortunately, it never got. Well, actually, no, I think it did. Side note, I bought this on Amazon, and it was advertised as the PAL copy, and then they sent me the this. Now it was a third party; it wasn't actually Amazon themselves, but they sent me the American version, and I hate it when sellers do that stuff. I mean, well, yeah, it doesn't really, really matter, and for me personally, it doesn't matter that much. But it's like, if I know it's going to be a US version, I'm fine with it, but I don't like being made to think I'm going to be getting a PAL version and then the US version shows up. Now, some of you might be thinking, well, Rob, it doesn't really matter, because the game will play anyway. And true, but should I ever decide to trade this stuff on at CEX or whatever, they won't accept it. They only accept PAL games, so I wouldn't be able to trade this in at a CEX, for example. Not that I ever would, but it's nice to have that option rather than have that option taken away from me, But anyway, in any case, rant over. I'm happy to get it. It's a great game, and definitely if you like 2D fighters, guys, it's definitely one to check out. So that's it in terms of games. Like I say, haven't bought much. Actually, no. Wait, hold on one second. Let me get this. I could have sworn. Yes, I do have one game. Sorry about that, guys. I'm a bit all over the place because it has been a while since I've made a video. But I did buy one more game. Yeah, I bought a PlayStation 2 game. And now, I don't buy PlayStation 2 games anymore. I'm actually very happy with my PlayStation 2 collection. Very, very happy with it. But I came across this game at CEX, and it's actually a game that has been on my list for a long, long time. And I've refused to buy on eBay and stuff. I just thought to myself, look, if I come across it in the wild, I'll pick it up. Now, this game is not rare or anything like that at all, but surprisingly, I never come across it. I think in the early days, I did used to come across it, but I wasn't looking to pick it up then. And then the more I found out about this game, the more I wanted it. And then when I wanted it, I just couldn't find it in stores anymore. So anyway, every time I go into CEX every now and again, it's always worth looking at the PS2 section just to see what's there. And I finally came across it. And the game I'm talking about is The Mark of Cree. And as you can see, I got it for £1.50. And what's very cool about this game, it's like a stealth game. It's a stealth action game. But I love the look of it. It's got this sort of kind of what, Polynesian, like soldier, you play like a Polynesian type character. And I remember this game getting a lot of good reviews. And it's considered a bit of a gem in the PS2 library. And it's always been on my radar to get, but like I say, I've just never been able to find it in the wild. So I'm very glad to finally get it now. So, like I say, I'm not really picking up for the PS2. In fact, I haven't really been picking up for the PS2 in the longest time. But this was a game that was definitely on my list. I just never came across it. So I'm finally glad to get that as well. So that is it. That is it in terms of games. The rest of this video is going to be Blu-rays. So if games is all you came to see, guys, then thank you very much for sticking around. Very much appreciate it. Of course, give it a thumbs up. Very much appreciate it. But for those that want to stick around, these are all going to be basically Blu-rays and DVDs as well. Now, I think I'm going to turn the light on because it's looking a little bit dark, so just bear with me one moment. Okay. Yeah, so I'm sort of filming this in the afternoon, so I think I'm losing my light, so hopefully that's a little bit better, guys. Anyway, moving on. First thing I picked up, and now, as you guys know, as you've probably been watching my videos, you know, I'm a big fan of Dragon Ball Z. It's definitely been a series that I absolutely loved for many, many reasons. Absolutely loved that series. So I finally decided to pick up the original series that came out. If you don't know, guys, basically Dragon Ball Z is actually a follow-up series to Dragon Ball, which was a series that started off as a comic. And the main character, Goku, in the series, in Dragon Ball Z, he's an adult, but the series actually started from when he was a little kid. And the early Dragon Ball series is basically sort of more of an action adventure, whereas the Dragon Ball Z series is more of sort of like a more straight up action fighting superheroic kind of stuff. But the like I say, the earlier series, more action adventure-y. It does have fighting, it does have a lot of superheroic sort of things going on as well, but just not as much as Dragon Ball Z. Dragon Ball Z kind of shifted focus, whereas the earlier series was more action adventure-y, travel the world, get into various adventures, and it's a lot of fun. I've been really enjoying it, so I picked up the entire run of Dragon Ball Z, as you can see here. So you've got this is Goku basically as a kid. This is season one. And if I just show you the last season, that's Goku again, as basically in his sort of, I say, late teens. And yeah, so that's basically season five, which is the last, and that's the first. And yeah, just really, really been enjoying this. I'm only into season two at the moment, and I'm looking forward to watching the rest. Yeah, loving them. I've never really watched them before as a kid. I've seen bits and pieces here and there, and they make a lot of references to the adventures that happen in this series in Dragon Ball Z, so it's always nice to sort of go back and check out, where some of the characters and villains and even the heroes, how their relationships were first founded in this series. So it's just nice to have. So yeah, I just decided to pick up the entire run on DVD. These are the official UK releases, so yeah, very happy to have. Now, okay, so next animated thing I got here. This is an animated superhero film from the US, and I picked up Justice League, Gods and Monsters. This is the most recent DC animated film. And what this is basically about, it's sort of based around Batman, Superman, and Wonder Woman, but in an alternate dimension. So these characters are like very, very different to how we're normally used to seeing them. This, I gotta say, this is actually a bit of a risk because when they first showed the trailer to this, I wasn't actually very interested in. The characters were just too different. I wasn't quite sure what this was really about, and initially I wasn't going to check this out, but the reviews of this have been great. So I thought, you know what, I'll check it out anyway. And I'm so glad I did. This is fantastic and very, very adult. I'd probably have to say this is one of the most violent DC superhero adaptions I've ever seen. This is definitely not aimed at children. And as you can see, it's gotten a 15 certificate. Yeah, it's definitely geared towards adults. This is not for children. Very, very cool. Very different, but very, very cool. Very dark as well. And an interesting take on otherwise, you know, very well-known characters. And definitely something to check out. Probably won't appeal to people that only have a very casual interest in superheroes. Just because it's so different. And if you're not really familiar with alternate Earths and whatnot, then I don't know how much you'll get from this, but it's definitely, you can enjoy it on that take of, you know, just this just being a different version of established characters. So yeah, very much enjoy this one. This is definitely a high recommendation if you like, you know, animated superhero movies. Next thing I picked up, this was basically just an impulse buy. I saw it at CEX and decided to pick it up, and that is Conan the Destroyer, the sequel to the original Conan the Barbarian. Yes, this is definitely a much weaker film than the original, but the completionist in me had to have it. I've always loved Conan. I love the Arnold Schwarzenegger interpretation of Conan, so I had to have the sequel. I saw it there for a fiver, so I thought I'd pick it up. Next thing I bought, and that is the American Pie 4 film collection. Now, back in the day, I was actually a very big fan of the American Pie series. I remember I've seen all of them at the cinema. I saw the first one in 99 and then saw the film subsequently. They used to appeal to me at the time because I'm roughly about the age of the characters, so you know, it felt like it was mirroring, you know, as I was getting into that sort of age. I think the characters were a little bit younger, not the actors themselves, but the characters obviously were in high school. By the time this film had come out, I'd already finished school. But you know, they're roughly sort of mimicking, well, not mimicking, but like just sort of trajectory of life was around the same time as where I was, and these were definitely a lot of fun to watch. The first two films are very, very cool, very funny movies. The third one, American Wedding, it was a bit of a disappointment, but to be honest. And the follow-up, the last one, American Reunion, which came out not too long ago, actually, I felt was a bit of a letdown as well. Just there wasn't much to it personally. It didn't feel like they had a lot to say, and yeah, it just kind of came and went, basically. But the first two films are great. I love them, and you know, the last two are worth to watch. You know, they're worth a watch. You know, they're just not as great as the first two films. So yeah, pick that up. And next thing I picked up, this is a box set that I've actually been wanting to get for a while. It's from a series of films that I absolutely loved as a kid. I used to watch these films so much when I was a youngin'. So I'm glad to finally own them on Blu-ray, and that is the Police Academy collection. Yeah, but believe it or not, I used to when I was a kid. There were two series of movies that I used to watch all the time, and this was one of them, and the other one was the Carry On series. I used to. I don't know why, I just really enjoyed them as a kid. And with regards to the Police Academy series, yeah, I just loved them. I just think they were funny at the time. I mean, to be honest, you know, watching them now, you know, they have dated, but The first movie, I mean, there's seven movies in this series, and the first movie to me is still the best. It's still the funniest. It's a great, great movie in its own right. The sequels are certainly a lot weaker, but some are still better than others. And the last movie, Police Academy 7, I've still yet to watch it. I watched it way back in the day, and I remember not liking it at all. I don't think I'm gonna like it. I'm still working my way through it. I've so far watched the first four in the series and I've enjoyed them. But I still haven't seen Police Academy 5 and 6. But for me, the film with the most nostalgia is Police Academy 6. I actually did see that film at the cinema when I was a kid, and I really enjoyed it. So for me, Police Academy 6 has the most nostalgia for me. That and the first one. They're the ones that sort of stuck with me the most. The 2, 3, and 4, I kind of jump between them, and I'm not looking forward to watching 7 just because my memories of it were not very good. I remember even as a kid, I think I pretty much did not like that film at all. So, but I'm glad to get this box set as yeah, they're just fun comedy films. Always enjoyed it, but yeah, a little known fact about me. I'm a big, big fan of Police Academy. Even when I was a kid, I even watched the cartoon series as well. Really enjoyed the cartoon series. The 80s was a funny time. We used to get a lot of these stuff that was originally geared at adults, and then they would eventually go on to make cartoons of them. Like Robocop was another example. For whatever reason, kids just latched onto the series, so they eventually geared the series towards kids, for better or worse, but that's what they did in the 80s. But yeah, very, very chuffed to get this as well. Next film I picked up, well, it's two movies in one, it's a compilation, and definitely great, great films, and that is The Fly 1 and 2. So it's got the original, well, not the original, remake, directed by David Cronenberg of The Fly with Jeff Goldblum, which everyone knows, classic horror film. And why I bought this was because it also has The Fly 2 with Eric Stoltz. And in my opinion, The Fly 2 has got to be one of the most underappreciated movies. I think for me, The Fly 2 sits there with Predator 2 and Robocop 2 as some of the most unappreciated sequels to come out. People, for whatever reason, just shit on these movies. I don't know why, because they're great films. They're great films. I mean, yes, I completely agree. They are not as good as the original film. I agree. Robocop 2 is not better than Robocop 1. Predator 2 is not better than Predator 1. And The Fly 2 is certainly not better than The Fly 1. But it's a great movie. And it was a great story. It definitely was. They did something new with it. It added to the mythos. It wasn't just a rehash of the first film. They did something different with it. And it was natural. It didn't feel forced. It was a great storyline, and I definitely recommend people check out The Fly 2 if you haven't seen it. Definitely check it out, or better yet, just buy this. I mean, brand new. It's only a fiver, so I mean, some people have picked it up recently. I can't remember who it was now. Oh, it really bugs me. I saw it in a video. Someone picked it up for a quid, at a car boot. So, in any case. Definitely worth checking out, guys. The Fly 1 and 2. Awesome series of films. So, really, really chuffed to get that as well. And the last two movies I picked up were actually Steelbooks. It's been a while since I've been picking up Steelbooks. Now, there was actually supposed to be a third Steelbook here, but it hasn't arrived yet. It's taking its sweet time. But I have two here in the meantime, and the first one I picked up, and this is one of my favourite films. Now, well, they're both some of my favourite films. I've decided basically, anything outside of Marvel movies, if I'm going to get them in Steelbook, they need to be films that I really love, like top tier movies that for me just I rank really highly. So these two definitely fall into that category. And the first one that I picked up is Training Day with Ethan Hawke and Denzel Washington. I love this movie. I absolutely love this film. I don't really want to say too much about it, but it's just basically just a fantastic. It's essentially about a guy who is going on his first day with his supervisor because he wants to become a detective, and he slowly realizes that his supervisor is kind of crooked, and that's to put it mildly. But it's a fantastic film. I don't know, it just resonates with me so much. It's just brilliant. Definitely worth checking out if you haven't checked out Training Day. It's definitely got one of my favourite Denzel Washington performances in this film. He plays a great villain, and that's not spoiling it. It's kind of from the off. It's kind of a given. He plays a great villain, and it's just an enjoyable watch. So yeah, very happy to get this in Steelbook. I did hold off for a bit. I waited for the price to come down a little bit, which it did. Not by much, but it did come down a bit. So in any case, very glad to own this on the Blu-ray Steelbook. And lastly, the next Steelbook I got here, and this is one that I was actually very excited to get. Now initially I missed the initial run of this, but I'm glad that they put out more stock, as I was looking forward to getting this in Steelbook, and that is Jim Carrey's The Mask. Again, you know, I mean, most of you have probably seen this film already. It's such a fantastic film, one of my favourite Jim Carrey performances, and yeah, just so chuffed to finally get this, not only in Steelbook but also as a Blu-ray, because I've been meaning to upgrade for a long time. And like I say, it's one of my favourite films, so really chuffed to get it. And I have unsealed this one, so you can have a look back here. It's got some nice artwork to show you the inside as well. Got some great artwork there. So yeah, really chuffed to get The Mask. So yeah, so that's basically it, guys, in terms of all the Blu-rays and stuff. And just as to cap it off, there is actually one more game. Like I said, guys, I'm all over the place. It was at the bottom of my pile here. I forgot I had it, but it's nothing special. Basically, I picked up Batman Arkham Asylum again. I already have this game, but I picked it up again mainly because it had a slip case and it was a regular edition. Been meaning to pick it up. It was 8 quid. Bought it at CEX. Yeah, just wanted to replace my current copy of it as well. So that's about it. Again, sorry guys. That's it. That is it. Thank you very much for watching, guys. Thank you for being patient as well. I appreciate it. I know some of you guys have been asking where I've been at. Like I say, you know, it's just it's partly because my head's not really been in it. And you know, I've always said this, and I know some of you agree with this as well. If you're not really feeling it, don't make a video, because people will know if it's forced. You know, don't make a video if you don't want to make a video, and that's my philosophy as well. So lately, I haven't really been feeling about making videos, and while I will be putting out content between now and New Year's, things will be a lot slower, unfortunately, just for various reasons I just don't want to get into. But you know, you will see videos. I haven't gone away. I've not quit YouTube. Nothing like that at all. Just things will be going a little bit slower between now and New Year's, but hopefully things will resume in a lot more regular pace in the new year. So thanks again, guys, for watching. Thanks to everyone that stuck around to the very end of the video. I very much appreciate it, and yeah, I'll be back at some point soon. Bye bye.